Welcome to our channel. Subscribe and join our zoo community. Today's video is about 15 life hacks to help you survive. Before jumping into the video, don't forget to hit the like button and show us some love. It is better that you should be fully prepared for any situation. You should have all the resources for your survival. But life is not a neat little package, it is complex. You may end up getting in a tricky situation where the required tools may not be available. So, keep the survival life hacks in mind and be prepared for any tricky situation that may arise. Let's take a look at 15 life hacks to help you survive. 15. Make compass with leaf, water, and a needle. You can't afford to get lost in case of survival situations, and the situation can get worse if you don't have a compass with you. Luckily, there's a way to make a compass with water, needle, and a leaf. The important part is to have a metal to act as a needle for the compass. An actual needle would be ideal for this purpose. Now all you need is a steel container for the water. Use a leaf to keep the needle floating. Without the counteracting forces at play, the floating needle will point towards the north and south. This was definitely a handy tip. If you stick with us till the end of the video, you will get to know even more useful tips. 14. Applying ice to a bruise. There is no doubt that ice helps to reduce the bruises, but you should be careful while using it. This is because applying an ice pack directly to your skin can result in a cold burn, and it may also end up irritating the bruise. Therefore, you should put the ice in a cloth so that there is a barrier between the skin and the ice. Then, in order to reduce the bruises, apply the cold pack on your bruise for 20 minutes and then remove it. Now wait for 20 minutes, and then repeat this process several times. 13. Dealing with a foreign object in the eye. Eyes are the sensitive organs of the human body. You should be careful while dealing with them, especially when there is a foreign object stuck in your eyes. If there is something in your eyes that feels like a piece of glass, don't do anything by yourself. Ask for help and have someone drive you to the hospital. If it is an eyelash, then make sure to wash your hands before dealing with it. Try to locate that eyelash using a mirror. You should blink so that the tears can wash the eyelash out. If the object is in the corner of the eye, use a clean and wet piece of cloth to use it and remove it. 12. Applying ointment to the wound. The over-the-counter ointments have unwanted moisture. This can favor a good environment for the growth and reproduction of bacteria. This is something that you won't like to have. The best way to deal with wounds is to clean them with cold water and then apply a dry bandage on it. You will notice that the wound will heal more quickly. 11. Lifting up an unconscious person. You may be of the thought that if someone faints, lifting the person and then sprinkling water on the face will do the work, but it is not right. Lifting the person will only aggravate the spasm. What you need to do is lift up the legs and unbutton any tight piece of clothing. You should not make them stand up right after it. They should also not drink energy drinks or coffee as it may lead to dehydration. 10. Rubbing a person with a fever with alcohol or vinegar. Both vinegar and butter can get absorbed into the blood. Rubbing someone with alcohol can lead to intoxication, and rubbing with vinegar will increase the acidity. This can be very dangerous for children. The best way to deal with fever is by drinking a lot of water and making the room cool. These conditions will help the patients to overcome fever by themselves if it's not too high. 9. Get a fire in a pinch. The difficult part of camping is to light a fire if you don't have any necessities. But don't worry, we have some fun way for you to achieve this. You can use alcohol swabs to get the fire started if you can't do it without tinder or starters. Alcohol is highly flammable and it will catch fire immediately. Besides this, you can also use Doritos. Yes, you heard it right. This is one of the fun ways to light a fire. Believe it or not, these chips can catch fire very easily and they will get it started in a minute. You can also achieve this with various other similar snacks. You can also use a cotton ball or a pad and wax. The cotton must be dry and you have to dip it in the melted wax. This will get the fire started. 8. Smoky fire can work well as insect repellent. Although bug bites may not sound like a big deal to you, but they have the risk to transfer life-threatening diseases to you. Suppose you are camping and you have any repellent to save you from the insect bites and diseases, then these survival tips will surely come in handy. Fire is the number one survival hack for this situation. It can be of great use as it gives you warmth, allows you to boil and disinfect the water, create light, and cook the food. But another great use of fire is that it can keep away the harmful insects, because the smoke caused by the fire can act as a repellent and it will protect you from the insects as long as you stay near it. But if you face breathing problems due to the cloud of smoke, then you can use some natural plants that are perfect substitutes for repellents. For this, you need to rub the oils of marigold, lavender, rosemary, catnip, citronella, or a combination of these on your skin. 7. Magnify and protect the heat of small candles. If you live in cold climates, then you will definitely get in a situation someday to create heat when there is no electricity. It is great to light up a fire when you are camping, but it can be dangerous to do so in houses. Don't worry, we have an amazing life hack for this. You can project the heat of small candles using terracotta pots to create warmth inside. If you have a large terracotta pot, all you need to do is put some candles underneath it and turn it upside down. But if you have small pots, put single candles under some of them strategically throughout the room. The terracotta pots conduct heat, and you will be surprised to notice the warmth that will radiate out. 6. Using superglue to close the wounds. Stitching the wounds can be a very long and painful process. Not only this, it also requires to remove the stitches later. But there is actually an interesting hack for this situation. You can use superglue in this case. The use of skin glue will give you two advantages, like it is quick and it is virtually painless. To use it properly, you need to stop the bleeding first of all by applying pressure. Carefully clean the wound. Now, close the edges and apply a skin glue. Wait until the glue dries. 5. Pulling objects from wounds. You can carefully pull out a splinter or a small piece of glass from your hands or your feet, but never try to do this when the wound is serious. This can lead to serious consequences. Even the doctors keep these objects in place until the patient is in surgery, because in the opposite case, extreme bleeding will occur that may lead to death. However, a knife in a leg or a huge shard in the chest may look scary, but the best thing to deal with it is to take the person immediately to the hospital instead of helping them to pull out the object. 4. Make yourself vomit in case of poisoning. The standard recommendation for poisoning is that you should make yourself vomit, but it should be avoided when the person has been poisoned with alkali, acid, or other dangerous substances. The best way to deal with it is to go to the hospital immediately. But if you are still sure that the vomiting will do you good, then don't use baking soda, manganese, or milk to induce it. Instead, you should drink a lot of water. 3. Applying warmth to a sprain. Applying a warm cloth or heat pack will be a bad idea if you have your muscles sprained, because the heat will strengthen the blood flow and it will lead to severe swelling. This can get extremely painful. The best thing to do is to apply a cold pack to it for the first few days of the injury. It will lessen the pain and the inflammation. You should also make sure that the affected muscles have to deal with minimum load for the first 48 hours. 2. Setting a bone on your own. You should never try to set a dislocated joint on your own. It will only lead to additional injuries. The best thing to do is immobilize it and then get the victim to the hospital. The limb should not be set forcefully. While immobilizing it, you should also cover the closest joints as well. 1. Using butter or sour cream to treat burns. The only reason that you will feel better is that the substances are cold, but when they are dry, they will disrupt the thermal exchange. Instead, you should hold the affected area under cold water for 15 minutes. You should never try to burst the blister burn, as it may cause infections and lead to festering. You've just watched 15 life hacks to help you survive. If you have tried any of these hacks, share your experience with us in the comments below. Thanks for watching Life Hack Giraffe. Please make sure to click the bell button and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos. We hope you liked it. See you in our next video.